I'm Charlene Simon with Bathhouse, Soapery, and Caldarium, and my favorite soap making tool that we have are the pumps that we put on our 55 gallon drums. So each drum has an individual oil that's part of our soap recipe, and these pumps make it super easy for us to individually put each oil into our master batch soap making recipe. So I'm going to show you how it works. First, we put our goggles on for safety, of course, and then we're going to crank up the power. Saves us a whole lot of time and allows us to pour in one day 12 30 pound molds that have about 74 bars of soap in them, making about 850 bars a day. So thanks to that pump, we save a lot of time and we make a lot of soap.
Hi there, I'm Amie Pearson of Mama Pearson Soaporium in Gas City, Indiana. We are a bath and body skincare store. We sell all kinds of products that we make ourselves. And I was asked by Kathy McGinnis of Soaping101 what was one of my favorite tools in my soap room. So I came up with my bucket opener tool. I love this tool. I believe I received this as a free gift at SoapCon, of one of the years that I went to SoapCon, or it could have been the Guild conference, but it was probably SoapCon. It says it's from soapequipment.com. Thank you, Soap Equipment. Couldn't live without this tool. Let me just show you how I use this tool. These are buckets of coconut oil. I buy them like this. They are kind of really hard to open. See, I would try to get it all open with my fingers, and it hurts your fingers. When you're in a hurry to open up a bucket of coconut oil, you're in the middle of measuring soap oils. You want it to be easy. So how you use this tool, you just go along and you just pop up all the little things here. So much easier to do it this way. So much easier. So I pop them all up and voila, the bucket is open. If I did not have this tool, I will hunt you down and I will find out what you did with my tool to take it from me. I have to have this tool in my soap room at all times. It's a great tool. Some things that we use coconut oil for, we use it in a lot of things, soap being the number one ingredient, but we also use it for other things like a solid lotion, Happy Feet. We put it in our all natural deodorant, and we also put it in our shampoo bars. You can use coconut oil for all kinds of things. But thank you, Kathy, for asking us what our favorite tool is. The bucket opener tool. Can't live without it.
Hi. My name is Brandy McClurg, and I own Bubble Time Soap. I was asked to do a video about my favorite soap making tool. Well, these are my favorite bath bomb tools. They're silicone basting brushes. They have little soft fingers that will remove the excess material from around your Saturn ring without damaging the bath bomb. So let me make a bath bomb real quick and show you what I'm talking about. I'm using mango sorbet, and it smells absolutely amazing. Okay, see all the residue above the Saturn ring? So I'm gonna just take my brush, done. Looks very professional, doesn't tear up the bath bomb, and it's super quick. We here at Bubble Time Soap make a bunch of different bath bombs. I can make all different sizes, shapes. We do custom orders, wholesale orders. If you would like a gift basket, we do shower steamers, different items like that. Check out our Facebook page. And also, if you'd like to shoot me an email, it's headbubblemaker@gmail.com. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Jackie Thompson, author of Liquid Soapmaking. Today, I want to talk to you about the taping knife, one of my favorite tools in the soap shop. It has so many uses and it can be found in any department store. For example, I like to use it to cut up my fats and butters. It's easier than a spoon and it is safer than a butcher knife. Also, because I'm a messy soap maker, I like to use it to clean up my spills and my messes. For example, on my countertops, I just scrape it along and scrape up all my liquid soap that I spill, all my shaving soap that I spill, and then I go over it with alcohol. After that, I clean up my soap mold. My wooden soap molds, the excess soap that I always seem to spill, and it just slides right off. Just like that. The taping knife, indispensable in the soap shop.
Hi, I'm Tracy Heppes from Tracy Heppes Creations, and I'm here to talk to you about my favorite soaping tool. So my favorite soaping tool is this little mini mixer. It comes with about 4 or 5 different attachments, but this is the only attachment that I use. I don't know if you can see it, but I love this thing. I use it for everything. I use it for mixing like my unsweetened flavor oils with some agave nectar to make lip balm. It's one of the things that I really love to do. You can kind of see that. And then what I do with that is I pour it into my mixture, my lip balm base that I've already got heated up, warmed up. Stick it in there. I know you can't see this, but I'm going to show you here in just a few seconds. And then I use it to mix the flavor in into my base. So that is one of the many things that I like to do. See if I can kind of show you from here. And that gets a little foamy, so what I'll do is I'll let it sit for a little bit longer before I try to put it into my lip balm tubes. But that's one of my favorite things to do with that. The other thing I really like to use it for is for mixing my colorants. So if I have some of my micas or pigments, and then I pour into my base to try to get it, or my olive oil is what I'm using for this. And just use it to get it all mixed up and integrated so that when I put it into my olive oil or into my soap base, that it gets mixed up a little bit easier. But this one's perfect for me because it's small, and I do everything in small batches right now because I'm just kind of a small business and trying to get started. But if you want to see any of my lip balms or any of my other creations, feel free to go to TracyHeppesCreations.com and check it out. Thanks, and I hope you enjoyed watching. Bye-bye.
Hi everyone, it's Clyde, and I was thinking about what my favorite soaping tool has been over all these years, and one thing came up from a variety of reasons, and it's this knife right here. One thing is I'm sort of emotionally attached to this, so it's affectionately named Pinky, not just by me, but people who have seen the videos. It was the first thing I used to cut my first soap, so it's got that kind of attachment. It was my way into soaping, so I really like it. But above the what feelings I have for it, I mean, this knife, it cuts the soap so that the surface of the soap is like glass. And I remember some of my soaps that I used to use this more often on, people would say, how do you get the surface so shiny? So I now use a wire cutter, but I wanted to show you the difference between this glass finish with this knife and what happens when you use a wire cutter. So I'm gonna move my setup so I can show you that. So here's my wire cutter, which I really like a lot too. It was made for me. And I'll show you what happens with the wire cutter. somehow the wire cutter leaves a pebbled surface on soap. Now watch, it won't happen this time. It's actually cut pretty smoothly, but probably not like glass. So I'll show you what it looks like with a knife. The other difficult thing with a knife is to cut it exactly right. So I have to get myself right over the soap and approximate 1 inch width as well. So look at my other soap. And let's go down here. What I liked when I first started soaping was seeing other soap makers cut through their soap in that way, that the knife slipped through the soap like this. It was very calming to me. I thought, I want to make my own soap just so I could cut it. Okay, so yeah, and you can see the sheen from this knife. So I think any flat knife would do. You can see this is a side cut with the wire cutter, and it looks more matte. And this one looks like gloss. So it takes a little bit more to get that straight cut. But my favorite tool of all time is Pinky the knife.
Hi everybody, Cory here from 10 Acre Woods. Today I am going to be showing you one of my favorite tools in my workshop. Very often I'm looking for a very specific color, and sometimes I may not have it, or I want it faster than I can order it, or you know, any sort of circumstance like that. A couple of years ago, I took a class by the very talented Carrie Thornsberry at SoapCon and learned how to mix colors in my favorite tool. And this is it. And we got it from her, and it's just a tool for mixing colors. It's like a little blender that you put the colors in and you blend them together. So they're not just two colors that are mixed, they actually become a different color, which I just love. Today, I'm going to be trying to come up with the perfect periwinkle color. Okay. So, two of the sky blue. Or two parts, so actually four sky blue. And when I was talking to Kathy about doing this experiment and doing this video, she had said that she had talked to Carrie, and Carrie had more of these mixers and that she was considering putting them on her website. So if you're interested, you could probably get one from her, which is where, you know, after our class, I got ours, or mine. Okay, so I've got four drops, or four of the sky blue and two of the iris purple. And so we're going to go ahead and try that. And I just let it go for a minute or so until it looks as though it's totally incorporated. Which it does. So let's try this. Oh, that's beautiful. I think this is going to be it. And so you can see that. That's beautiful. I think that's the right color. Yes. Okay. So, this is the periwinkle that I was going for. I hope that that is coming through really well. The color of that is coming through really well. That is how I go about mixing up my colors. So if you have any questions, you can get in touch with me. Again, I'm Cory at 10 Acre Woods, and you can reach me on my website, which is 10acrewoodsoapsandsuch.com, or just shoot me an email, which is corypenton@gmail.com. Okay, thank you.
Hi, it's Kathy from Soaping101, and my favorite soaping tool is the bartender spoon. It is without a doubt the most reached-for tool in my studio. I use the back of it for pouring layers in my soap. It keeps them from breaking through. I use it to create the easiest spoon swirl design. It's long enough to reach through all the layers. And I use the spoon to create the pretty peaks on top of my soaps. The bartender spoon. It's not just for cocktails.